So assalamualaikum Puan.
Assalamualaikum.
Okay, so we are with Puan Hajjah Kamariah binti Mohd Noor, our registrar here at OUM University Malaysia, and Puan Kamariah is here to talk with us about the qualities of an excellent OUM learner. Okay, Puan. Without further ado, let's dive right into our first question. Who is the OUM learner? What should be his or her characteristics?
Okay. I think I would like to answer that question from another perspective first, before I can direct to your question. In terms of OUM learners, they are actually people who are looking for opportunities to improve themselves. They are those who believe that in order to be good at what they do at work, they have to be professional. That means they are guided by the discipline which is required in their work. So in order to be such a person, they have to be a knowledge seeker, and they have to be independent, and they have to be a very avid problem solver. At the same time, they have to have a very high achievement orientation. So I would say those would be the characteristics of OUM learners, and these characteristics are driven by my earlier part, earlier part of my answer, where I said that they are those who are passionate about their work. They realize the value of knowledge, the value of skills, and then the value of professionalism. Because with knowledge and skills added to these two, will be the resulting effect is the professionalism. So that would be my response to your first question.
Okay, Puan. Here at OUM, I mean, you mentioned it earlier, it is important to have self-discipline, learners who are self-disciplined. And of course, a big component in learning in OUM is actually to keep your self-discipline, as well as to keep yourself motivated, the learners especially, to keep them motivated. Can you share with us, with our learners, what motivates you, Puan?
Okay, very good question. As a person, I am motivated by goals and targets. Goals and targets are what drive me to work every morning, drive me to plan what needs to be done. And certainly the goals and target have to be derived from the expectation of the stakeholders, expectation of the group of people that you are supposed to serve. So to me, these are most important, and this should be guided by the profession that we are in.
Okay, Puan. Of course, in OUM, we are very, very learner-centered, and some of our learners are actually come from diverse backgrounds, and some of them may not be excelling. I mean, they have different expectations, different definition of achievement. So, Puan, do you think grades, good grades, are a good indication of achievement? Why so, Puan?
Okay, good grades to me are not everything in life. They are the other dimension where employers look for. Sometimes I would like to put it in this way. Employers are looking for employees who are able to connect the dots. Because in life, things are not as straightforward. One must be able to analyze using a minimum information which is given. That's why I use the word able to connect the dots. And also most important is that the employees or the prospective employees, they must be able to communicate well, articulate their views, and then they need to have to be good team players. Nowadays, being a good team player is no longer a desirable criteria, but rather a mandatory criteria. And of course, very important also for them, they must be able to see things from a bigger perspective and think outside the box. Some people say are very creative. And then at the same time, they must have a sense of reality, because they cannot be too imaginative, so much so that the solution they propose cannot be implemented, for example. So I would say it's asking quite a lot, quite a lot from the prospective employers. And certainly not all of this you can learn at the university. some of these characteristics you build over the years. Mm-hmm. Yeah? You build at your workplace or through your interaction with others.
Mm-hmm.
And last but not least, I would say good interpersonal skills.
Okay?
If you have good interpersonal skills, you work well with others,
mm-hmm.
Your views get heard, you know, and you are also flexible.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that would be what I would say the employee of the 21st century.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Okay, now when we have many learners, we have total cumulative learners of 100,000 over, and we have 40,000 over graduates. Okay, can you share a story that you are particularly fond of about our learners, or perhaps our graduate or our alumni, that you think will inspire our listeners or audience?
I never think of any such stories. I suppose there could be a few.
Mm-hmm.
Let me just think. There was one case of a student
mm-hmm.
who wanted to quit just because the learning center is not like 2 or 3 kilometers from her house.
Mm-hmm.
And I called her up when I saw her request for termination.
Mm-hmm.
I called her up. And she was so pleased that mm-hmm. That we do care about our learners.
I see.
And I think this was way back in 2006.
Mm-hmm.
And then I shared with her the experience I had when I attended a convocation from an IPTA.
Mm-hmm.
I attended this convocation and I saw this graduate
mm-hmm.
who was having with a disability.
Mm-hmm.
She was having a very difficult time to go up the staircase.
Mm-hmm.
She was on crutches,
mm-hmm.
and the convocation, she decided to go to the convocation,
mm-hmm.
she decided to get assistance
mm-hmm.
to walk up the staircase,
mm-hmm.
but once she is on the same stage? Floor, mm-hmm. yeah, on the stage, she walked by herself, of mm-hmm. course with the crutches,
mm-hmm.
and there were huge applause
mm-hmm.
in the hall,
mm-hmm.
and I think she got almost a standing ovation.
Mm-hmm.
And I related to this learner
mm-hmm.
about how the other person able to overcome all kind of adversity
mm-hmm.
and able to get the scroll in her hand.
Mm-hmm.
And I suppose the student who decided to initially withdraw from her studies
mm-hmm.
decided to come back.
I see.
So I suppose that's one of those beautiful moments,
mm-hmm.
wonderful moments that I can share.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And there will be many, many more.
Many more, inshallah.
Okay. So, Puan, we're almost at the end of our segment.
Yeah.
What would be the most important piece of advice that you'd like to share with our listeners, our audience?
Okay. This would be my favorite question, I suppose.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Life is about making the best of opportunities.
Uh-huh.
And then one must always believe in oneself,
mm-hmm.
yeah? Regardless of what your background is, regardless of what experience you have gone through life,
mm-hmm.
be it positive or be it negative,
mm-hmm.
always tell yourself that the past cannot control you,
mm-hmm.
but rather you can still plan what you want to be, still visualize what you want to be.
Mm-hmm.
You must have a strong belief in yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And last but not least, you must have a personal vision of what you want to be in the future.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, I think you should be able to achieve whatever that you set your mind to.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so thank you so much, Puan.
Thank you.
All right.